Hello and welcome to this week's Fast Recording Podcast with Ian and Jem. Yeah, we're going to have a chat about Fast Recording last weekend. What brilliant weekend it was, how much we enjoyed it. Also, we're going to have a chat about the new Glastonbury Festival lineup announcement. We have new music from Lost Trades, Shoto Gato and Lonely Taurus. But this, we're going to kick the show off with That Light by Eve Lacedi.
I need a little light in my life. I need a feeling of control. I need a tiny bit of sunshine in my soul. I need a spotlight in my mind to illuminate the shadows. I need the sunshine in my soul to grow. So I've got that little light, I'll never have to fight to put that tiny bit of sunshine in my soul. Once I've got that little light, I'll have a sparkle in my eye, because the sunshine in my soul has grown. So
okay, we kicked off the show with That Light by Eve Lacedi. And welcome to the Glastonbury Recording Podcast with Ian and Jem. Hi, Jem.
Hi, how are you?
Yes, not bad. Not bad. Warming up after pounding the streets today in the cold and the snow and the wet.
But I don't envy you, because there's lots of puddles, isn't it? Are you wearing shorts? Are there still...
No, I'm not wearing shorts today. Your God, no.
that tests the women from the girls, doesn't it?
I was well wrapped up. I was well wrapped up. Yeah, but it was okay. It's okay. We got through it. I'm looking forward to the spring. Well, we are in the spring, but I'm looking forward to spring type weather.
Well, we had it, didn't we? And then it's just kind of gone. But I think, you know, I like the idea of snow. It's just if you've got to go out and go and work in it, you've got no time to make your snow, your snow woman or your snow cat. You know, that's what you've got to make when it's snowy.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Well, a great weekend last weekend. We saw you at Glastonbury Calling as well. So we can do this in two sections. Chat about the Friday first, which was brilliant. All the bands were great there. We had a wonderful time. Kicked off with Adhama. She was really good, really, really rocky. And then Liquid State brought their own lighting rig, and absolutely, yeah, they were fantastic. And they mixed that in with a show. And then finally, Droogs rocked us all, and they were great. Everyone went down really well, and a nice, friendly crowd on the Friday as well. So it was fun.
Yeah, no, good. I don't know. I'm a bit in awe of the Friday night. I don't know if I'd fit in. I probably would, but you know, I'm going to do something. I'm going to go to the event in September when Max puts his rock metal and stuff on. But yeah, I listened to some Droogs on one of these streaming platforms. I thought I quite like them actually. So
yeah, they're really good.
I think I need to explore more.
Bits of rock and roll in there, bits of the Cramps, bits of, you know, it's like, you know, it's a good mix of stuff, you know, sort of, and they rock really well, sound great, you know, great for a three piece, really.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so definitely recommend people go and see them. If they haven't seen them yet, they've got gigs coming. I think they've got another one coming up in Bristol soon. So definitely go and check them online. But you get up to much else the weekend?
I think most of Sunday was spent... Well, Saturday we were down at a surprise party down in Dorset. And that was kind of all... busy. It wasn't boozy, it was just sort of tea and snacks and things, but it was lovely. And then we rushed back to think, well, can we make it a Glastonbury Calling? Needed an hour's sleep, truth be known. And then we kind of got ourselves up to you at the King Arthur and made it, which I'm really pleased to see the last bit of Bite the Buffalo. So that's what we did on the Saturday. Saw the last two and a bit acts. And Sunday, just kind of recovering. Do you know what? I had my phone on me. And on the Sunday, I was looking at my phone and saw that on the Saturday, I did like 12,000 steps. I've got any step things. And
yeah.
I don't use it in a worry. I just like to see. And obviously, exercise is great. And I love walking. And I just thought, I just haven't been out walking. So those 12,000 steps was just moving my feet around to Cosmic Ninja.
Good grief. So dancing on the spot.
Yeah. So Cosmic Ginger, Cosmic Ninja, or for me, Cosmic Grey, and balding, bald, is 12,000 steps a gig.
Oh, wow. Wow.
So really, you can say rock and roll is good for you.
Yeah, rock and roll is good for
you. It's healthy. You know, you get fit.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. No, like being a postman's good for you. I mean, I did blooming last week, 4 days, 90,000 steps.
Do you got? Have you got a stepometer as well?
It's on my watch. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, I was like, that's a lot.
It is a lot. Yeah,
that's a lot. So I'm getting fitter slowly but surely. So
you're probably also shrinking as you're wearing off your feet. You'll be down to my size sort of shortly.
Yeah, I'll probably
by
will
the
do.
End of the year. Yeah,
I probably will do. Wear myself down. Anyway, let's play some new music. This is a new track by the Lost Trades off of their new album, which is out on the 10th, which is this Friday, isn't it?
Yeah.
The album, I see if I can pronounce it right. It's Petiture, is that right?
I don't know. I love the Lost Trades, as you know.
Yeah.
They've played with us at previous Glastonbury Callings. I don't know how to pronounce it. And I often mispronounce and then feel terribly guilty. So I'm going to leave this on to you to.
Yeah, all right. Well, I think it's Petitchore because it's spelled P-E-T-I-C-H.
What does it mean?
I got no idea.
That's all my education comes from rock album titles.
Well, we'll play this track. I know what the name of the track means. It's Atlas. So we'll get on and play that.
Is Atlas holding up the sky on me? I wonder as I crumble to my knees, why the world I hold so dear just seems to disappear before my eyes. I feel like Atlas holding up the skies. I've walked this beach routinely, but it never seems to teach me. I know the lay of the land by the lines in the sand that I've drawn over the ones from before. I'm followed by my old friend who seems to spot the trend, but he's always too late and I'm tired of the weight that he loads onto my shoulder again. It's breaking my back, papering the cracks. Is Atlas holding up the sky on me? I wonder as I crumble to my knees, why the world I hold so dear just seems to disappear before my eyes. I feel like Atlas holding up the sky. Up to meet me, and it swallows me completely. Well, I think with a shrug that I'll learn how to juggle it all before I drop the ball this time. I've only just
but
Okay, Tell Her So by the Young Martyrs there, who played last time at Summerstock. I think that's when I saw him and met him. So, yeah, good stuff. So, yeah, so Lost Trades, all new stuff coming out. We've got loads of stuff to look forward to from them.
They're on tour as well, by the way. Selling out quite a few of their gigs. I know they're down at the Exeter Phoenix. I think they're just about to play or have played Axbridge, which is sold out. I don't know if they're coming around our part of the world. I'm not sure.
It's nice because I always get a nice little email from them. I expect you do as well.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, thanks
yeah.
for, you know, sticking with it. And that was the thing with, I played Eve Lasady at the start of the set. She played, I think she was playing at the O2 in London or something like that last week. Not the Brixton one of the other ones. She played there and her dad was at the Irie Fire gig and he came up to me and said, oh, let me get you a pint. He said, thanks very much for supporting my daughter all the time when she was younger, 15, 16. Mm. And she's sort of doing really well now and she's a professional musician based up in London. She earns a living from it. And he said, oh, thanks. And I was thinking, well, she would have been pretty done all right without me, I think.
Well, so, yes, they have the talent, but essentially where you've got, you know, everyone listening to Glastonbury Recording Podcast knows how much we all together support music and we love music. And it's good, great for up and coming musicians. It was like with Amber Chapman, who we saw, didn't we?
Yeah.
And it's just when, you know, when you're first starting up, it's all about building that self-esteem, avoiding self-doubt. And that's what you do. You offer that kind of confidence and that then is just like a springboard for the next level. So they never forget where they've come from. And that's
Because it is that people aren't used to doing interviews and that at that age and when they're coming through. So it's a good learning curve for them because doing that sort of thing is quite good. But yeah, we spoke about the Friday at Glastonbury Recording. The Saturday was fantastic. We kicked off with Jay Anderson, who was excellent, and then Zani, who's really challenges people. People either love him or don't love him, one or the other. But the people who are there who really get into it and really love it. And he does really well. One of the highlights, I think, for me was Flo Parker. I mean, it's the first time I've seen her with her band, and they were absolutely brilliant, really good. She had such a good band behind her. Phil Haller on the drums as well, who was used to be on Last One Home's drummer, but he drums for a lot of acts and that now. So, they had him. And so had a lot of good musicians with her. But her songs were just fantastic. So I really, really enjoyed that.
Before you carry on, I couldn't make it. Wanted to see her live. And I've seen some YouTube videos of her songs, and they're crafted. She's spent her time. She's been sort of working hard and building and building and building. So that's wonderful to hear. Did she mention anything about any sort of music releases? Because that's what I'm interested in.
Yeah, not really. I think they're recording. I think Nick's recording as well. So
that he is, isn't he? Yes.
He's
quite advanced on his album, actually.
Yes. Yeah. And like, I think the lad who played guitar in Flo's band, he was quite a young lad, but he's played on Nick's album as well, so that was really, you know, really looking forward to hearing some recorded material from her. Then the Pagans, SOH, everyone loved them. I mean, that was a bit of a coup, get them down and play at Art. They're a lovely bunch of guys, and get them to come down and play. And I mean, they were up headlining some festival up in Manchester, bearing in mind they're from the Midlands, headlining one of the days at a festival up in Manchester. So you think, well, that so was...
Did they come down specially for Glastonbury Recording? Or did they come down specially for Glastonbury Recording?
Yeah.
But again, that's about connections, isn't it? Because you saw them and then this happened. I never heard of them before. And when you mentioned it on a previous edition of the Glastonbury Recording podcast, I went away and sort of explored them. I really love them. Great. So, yeah, another one.
I know.
Yeah.
I know. And a real odd mix of people, real just bizarre, you know. The bass player reminds me of the, I've forgotten his name now, the wacky one out of Slade who used to dress with all the stuff. And he had this big fur, well, big fluffy coat on. And like someone said to him, "Oh, I really like your coat. Where'd you get it?" And he said, "I found it." And he just found it. He found it, not necessarily on the night, but he found it somewhere. So he just decided, you know, it was just left, so he took it home, washed it, and now it's his favourite coat.
If only the original owner would know that this coat is now turning into a super coat star.
Yeah, I know. They were really good. Who else did we have? Bite the Buffalo. They went down really well.
That's when I joined you. Just got the last quarter of the set, and they're brilliant. Love them.
Yeah. And also, Ruben's Daughters, who were fantastic.
That was an amazing set.
They were just beautiful.
You know what I like? What I like about them is that their set, and also the other group that they're in. Some of them are in Port Erin. They actually sound better live than they do on their recorded albums. I mean, they're craftspeople and how they put their music together, beautifully produced and recorded. But live, it takes it just to another level, I think.
Yeah. And 2 Day Coma on a little bit earlier. They went down that everyone loved down there, quite folky, rocky, but very like delicate songs. I mean, they're on, you know, and. I had a few people tell me that they were one of their favourite bands of the night as well. So it's good that everyone's coming out with different favourite bands. And then we had an extension late, so we finished at midnight and Cosmics were on. And I was just like thinking, oh, I hope the crowd stays there for Cosmic Ninja. And it was a really good crowd for them. It was, everyone stayed. It was still packed for Cosmic Ninja. They did their usual. I mean, they're just on top form, aren't they, really?
I love them, and I always do. And you obviously know the lead. I saw you were chatting to the lead singer, and she's amazing. Got a great attitude, really caring kind of person, and just gives it so much energy. Just this honesty in music is what I love about the Cosmics.
Yeah, I know. And they're back down in May as well. So
yeah, they are.
Well, we haven't got long to wait for them again. So being supported by Miss Kill. So yeah, keep your eyes out for that one. Okay, we'll play some more music now. Anyway, better say thanks to all the volunteers who helped out on the day. And also thanks to the King Arthur, and thanks to everyone who came, because I did write it in the post, like, bands and people like us who put stuff on, without those people coming up, we don't get to have our dreams of doing all this stuff, you know. So, you know, thanks. If we don't have the crowd, I mean, and we don't have the people coming who make it and absolutely buy into the whole thing, you know, it'd be a real struggle. But yeah, thanks to everyone who came down.
And what a crowd too.
Yeah.
There's something very special about the Glastonbury Calling crowd, and the links often link with you'll catch the same people at Godney, or there were people from Boss Fest and Watch It Festival, and it's family, isn't it? And each festival is at a different time, so it's really good to see old friends and young friends.
Right. We've got another new track now. This is from Shoto Dato, and it's called Enter Matador. It's a new track of theirs. Thank you. Okay, Miss You There by Giant Robot Bodies, who are another good festival band as well. So, yeah, really love them. Yeah, and talking of festival bands, Glastonbury Festival announced their lineup last week, which has gone and caused a bit of controversy, to say the least, I think.
Yeah, I saw that myself, and I don't know. The thing about Glastonbury Festival, you will always get those, the movers and shakers, and those that might have a little bit of criticism. And I can see the point that a lot of people have been making, but if you dig down beneath the initial lineup, you're always going to get a real cross of diversity and balance to the festival beyond the headliners. So, but I have to say, I understand that, because for me, when I look at the headliners, apart from Lizzo, I'm not really sure who else I would want to see.
Lizzo's not a headliner as such, is she? I think she's sub-headlining.
Yeah, well, she's on the top bit of the festival poster, so that's
I think they put her on the top bit just to sort of make it look like they've got a woman on the top.
Yes, it's true.
I mean, it's a bit... A lot of people have been complaining that it's quite blokey. And there's no female. I think they were saying, or there's a lot of things going around that Taylor Swift dropped out. But there's plenty of women out there for sure who are more than capable of headlining, I think. I mean, taking out the thing of, I mean, they've got Elton John headlining, Guns N' Roses, who have never headlined before. I think they'd be quite, and Arctic Monkeys. But between them, I think Elton John, you could go, yeah, he's been quite successful of late because he's done lots of new albums. His latest album had a lot of collaborations. He's gone to play on the piano, and he's always a fan of new. And I think he'll have quite a lot of people up there on stage with him and guesting. But I think
it's almost his last show. Real farewell tour. So, you know, I don't mind that. He was rumoured last year because he was at Bristol at the time of the festival, and rumours having it he was going to drop down for the Saturday night. So he's here because of that, I'm sure.
I think, like, between having three acts who are, I don't think any of them have really put in, you know, are a current band. Or a current artist, really, you know. It's quite, I mean, there's all the debate about women, but it is quite tired in a way because it's all bands from the past. It's not bands from now and the future, you know. And like they gave the leg up to Stormzy, I think they should have found a way of giving the leg up to someone and putting them on the stage, really.
I think if you drop down, we're talking about the current first wave of lineups, and actually if you drop down, you've also got Cat Stevens right at the bottom, Yusuf. That's why there's down there. But actually, if you look at Waze Blood, who I nearly went to see with my son in Brighton, she's great, and that's definitely a recommendation. You've also got Slow Tire is really taking off.
Yeah.
Go a bit further up, you know, you've got Carly Rae Jepsen, Amadou and Mariam. So you've got near the top of the list, obviously beginning with a blind singer. That's great. So there's a few there. And I think, so you've got, you know, Loyal Kana is really taken off. And I love his music. So
no, there's a lot of interesting stuff on the bill.
Yeah.
But I just think, you know, that, I don't know. I just think, and anyway, the other thing with me as well, you know, they haven't announced the legend slot, have they? There isn't a legend on there.
Unless it's Elton John. I don't know.
Elton John's headlining Sunday.
Okay.
I think Arctic Monkeys Saturday, Guns N' Roses Sunday, Elton John Monday. Sunday. Be funny if they did a Monday. I mean, why not have Blondie on the legend slot?
I think Blondie is there. I'm sure
she's... Blondie's on there.
Oh, I see. Yeah, but she's the same as Elton John.
I was surprised that they're not on the Legends. I mean, everyone knows Blondie songs.
Yes.
I said to Kieran, he said, my son, and he said, oh, that'd be a good shout. you know, I know a lot of their songs.
So for me, I love seeing like Tinara and sort of Desert Blues on the initial lineup, and also Sudan Archives. You know, this is kind of world stuff. And for me, I love Ezra Collective, so I'm really pleased about that.
Oh yeah,
and Christine the Queens. Let's give a big shout out for Chris, who I saw in 2019, didn't see much for whole sets, amazing, Christine. They are just incredible to watch live, and I'm really pleased that they're coming back to the festival. So I think give it a chance is my summary.
Yeah.
You've got Candy Staton, obviously, who's a legend in her own right, left field back. So I know what you mean. There's some of the kind of oldish guard. Does it matter? If there's other acts that actually are there and being supported on some of the other stages, it doesn't. Let's wait and see is what I say. There's still good stuff there to see.
Okay. Right. Well, we got another new track. This was sent in by Lonely Tourist. He's coming out on the 31st of the 3rd. So we've probably got this before the Mac got it, really, you know. So we're top of the list. I'm going to watch him in Bristol on the 1st of April. Yeah, all right. And no comments, please, Jem. But I'm watching him at Bristol on the 1st of April, supporting Gaz Brookfield. So looking forward to that. His brand new track out is called Duty of Care.
For those of us who still work here, he is just a memory. And all that remains as of him is his stationery. A hole punch with initials on, elastic bands into a ball, tens of thousand paper clips, a date stamp stopped at his last shift. I'm now using the dead man's stapler, using dead man's pens and the dead man's pieces of paper. We're all using the dead man's stapler. We can use what we like, cause it's not like he'll be in later. He was one of those blokes that you liked to work but he wasn't popular with the bosses. Too many hangovers, too many lates with fantastical excuses. We kill ourselves laughing at them upstairs until it came to getting paid. When you'd find yourself at a Friday bar, wasting it all on pints and Zambuca. I'm now using the dead man's paper, using dead man's pens and the dead man's pieces of paper. We're all using the dead man's stapler. We can use what we like, cause it's not like it'll be in later. The mundane things that you do in life go on, even when the folk you did them with are all gone. Him upstairs 2 weeks to say, or even just acknowledge, he'd passed away with sympathy. Well, sorry for your loss. For a man who hated work meetings, he'd have laughed a lot at the pitiful scene. They screened his funeral in a conference room space. We got 1 hour off, no boss showed face. Then we went back to the dead man's stapler, the dead man's pens and the dead man's pieces of paper. We all miss the dead man and his stapler. We miss him all right, and it's not like we'll see him later.
Okay, track there by a band called Night Swimming. We saw them at one Max's Rock Against Cancer last year. A track called Freight Train. Yeah, really, really good act. And yeah, there's lots on this weekend for people to see anyway. I'm off to a gig tomorrow night, Saturday, Thursday, weather permitting, because a band that we really like, Shame, are playing at the SWX. But they're at Liverpool tonight. So I'm hoping they don't get snowed in at Liverpool so we get a chance to see him tomorrow.
I don't know. I'm not a massive fan, sorry, venue, music venue of SWX. Yeah. It's quite long as a venue. Put on some really, really good music. I've only ever been there once, but if you're near the back and you're small, you can't see very much. So I'm sure you're in for a good gig. It's right in the centre of Bristol as well, aren't you? Near the Rough Okay. Road.
Well, gigs coming up this weekend for people who want to be out and about. There's the Electric Mother Funker with Dr. Arma Queen or Drama Queen at the King Arthur. Manus Pustaris Trio at the Art Bank in Shepton on Friday. Was that okay pronunciation? I thought
I've not heard of it. So sometimes I go on YouTube and then put in a name, say how to pronounce it, and I take ages. I think the thing is, you've given it a go, and unless you're corrected to learn for next time, okay, we'll go with that. Never heard of them, I'm afraid. I hope that they look sound interesting.
Yeah. On Saturday, Emily Breeze has got her album launch at the All Hallows Hall. There's a Turkey Syria fundraiser on at the Red Brick Building with Mobius Loop, Mika Sinclair, Chas 23 and Cub on at the Rifes. We're going to be down Weymouth, and there's a folk band on there called Masu, with two U's at the end of their name. One with one of them with apostrophe. And as well, for those who are interested in the Pilton Party, or the Pilton, not Pilton, but the Pilton Stage have two finals, one this week, one next week. This week they have, on the Saturday, they have Scribes, Bessina, Mike Dennis, Pretty Babs, Chevy Chase. I can't read my own writing. Chevy Chase Stole My Wife, I think it is. And Malativa and Gemma Johnson. And then on Sunday at the King Arthur, Michael Collings. So, lots on this weekend for you to go to, I think. Yep. Okay. Right. So, anyway... like I said, I'm heading down Weymouth this weekend. After all this, doing all the festival and that, Karen needs a haircut. And she's got my brother's partner's going to cut her hair this weekend. So that's going to be fun.
Where are they playing? Karen's got a haircut. They sound like an
interesting Karen's got name. A haircut, I know.
Yeah, great name for a band.
Yeah. Something like, we've got a first box and we're going to use it.
Now I will be down on the Saturday in Chard, where it's first of this whole sort of series of collaborations with the diverse communities of Somerset at Chard Together, which also goes to Bridgewater and Yeovil as well. So we'll be at Chard Together at the Guild Hall if you want to come and say hi. There'll be lots of activities. There'll be lots of good food from all over the world. Come and check that out if you're free during the day on Saturday at the Guild Hall, Chard.
Good food from all over the world. If that doesn't tempt anyone, don't know what will. Okay. Right, thanks a lot to everyone. Thanks for listening to the podcast. And we'll say goodbye, and we'll see you next week. Thanks very much, Jem.
Yeah, cheers, Ian. Lovely to see you. Lovely to catch up with you last week. And thanks for a great Glastonbury call in 2023.
Yeah, thank you very much. And we're going to play a track of Emily Breeze's new album. She's got her album launched this weekend. This has been played on Radio 6 as well. It's a track called Ordinary Life. And thanks to everyone, and we'll see you next week.
Back then, rent was cheap in the wrong parts of town. You could walk into almost any place and get a cash in hand job. I was a terrible waitress and an even worse singer. But I didn't care. I just knew something bigger, brighter, better was on its way. Someone was gonna spot me walking down Stokes Croft and say, hey, whisk me away into my glittering future. 20 years later, I'm still waiting. But you know what? There's nothing wrong. Definition surround sound love affairs and low budget B movie one night stands. Somehow it was always the end of the summer. And we dragged ourselves through the streets at dawn to our day job and dole office appointments, fueled on weapons grade hope and uncut dreams. And the days went by, and the days went by. Days went by like strobe lights. Yourself at a friend's 40th birthday party, wondering how the day has turned into decades, and if anyone still does drugs, and you will dance off the minutes and the moments, and the magic and the misery, yeah, the miracles and monotony as you want.